In the summer of 2019, the IRS started sending out letters for individuals with unreported crypto trading gains on their tax returns. Many of the investors were unaware of the tax implications when it comes to dealing with virtual currencies. With all of the different requirements from the IRS, you might be wondering, what's the best way to get involved with Bitcoin without triggering any unnecessary taxes? In this video, I'm going to talk about four ways to simplify Bitcoin taxes to avoid triggering any unnecessary taxing events. Welcome to CPA Explains. Please note, everything on this channel is for informational and entertainment purposes only. Please contact your tax attorney or CPA for your specific tax questions. The majority of Bitcoin and other cryptocurrency transactions happen on virtual currency exchanges. Although these exchanges give you their transaction history that you can download, it's your responsibility to actually calculate and understand all of the tax implications for any transactions you made during the tax year. One of the main ways you can reduce the reporting complexities is to limit the number of exchanges you're buying and selling on. Nowadays, there's hundreds of cryptocurrency exchanges listed on CoinMarketCap. By limiting the number of exchanges you use, you can minimize the number of reports you have to gather at the end of the year. Also, if you live in the United States and you're using foreign exchanges to buy and sell cryptocurrencies, you may be subject to FBAR reporting requirements. You are required to file an FBAR report if you hold over $10,000 in assets in any foreign bank account. This does apply to virtual currency exchanges, so make sure you're aware of those requirements. In the 2019 IRS guidelines, they specified that any airdrops that you receive on exchanges are treated as ordinary income for tax purposes. To reduce the number of airdrops you receive and the number of times you have to report income as it relates to virtual currencies that you're not really interested in, I would recommend limiting the number of exchanges you use and only dealing with US exchanges. The more transactions and trades you have on an exchange, the more work and complexity it's going to take to accurately calculate all of the taxable events and all of your different bases. Which brings me to my second point of how you can simplify your Bitcoin taxes. And the second way is to stick to Bitcoin. There's thousands of cryptocurrencies or altcoins available, but none of them have the history and network that Bitcoin has built. We've recently been seeing more institutional players within Bitcoin, and companies that are publicly traded, such as MicroStrategies, have now invested a large portion of their balance sheet into a Bitcoin. Jack Dorsey's company Square has also bought $50 million in Bitcoin. And recently, PayPal announced that you can now purchase Bitcoin on their platform. In 2017, we saw the rise of altcoins and ICOs, and most of those proved to be scams and illegitimate projects. So my recommendation is sticking to Bitcoin and not trading for any other cryptocurrencies, as that's just going to add additional risk and complexity to your tax returns. Now, if you are interested in getting into the price action of Bitcoin, but you don't want to sign up for a virtual currency exchange, you do have the ability to invest in the Grayscale Bitcoin Trust, which is a digital currency investment product that individual investors can buy and sell within their own brokerage accounts. Although it's not an ETF, it's treated like one, and you're not actually buying Bitcoin, but you're investing in a trust that is backed by physical Bitcoin. I always recommend owning and holding your own Bitcoin and private keys, but this does allow you to get into the price action of Bitcoin, and this also allows you to take tax advantages on your retirement accounts, such as your IRA and Roth IRA. And finally, one of the easiest ways to minimize any taxing events is to just hold and not sell any of your Bitcoin. If you're a true believer in Bitcoin, you're in this for the long run and not just in it for a quick gain. Most people aren't traders, and if you're like myself, you're just looking to buy as much Bitcoin as possible and watch the number go up. When you're buying Bitcoin on any exchange, that doesn't cause any taxable events. So I recommend buying Bitcoin using the dollar cost average method, where you're just buying Bitcoin no matter what price it's at, once a week, once a month, or at any specified time frame that you feel comfortable with. By doing this, you're buying Bitcoin at the low prices and at the high prices, no matter what it is, so at the end of the day, you're always going to average out. And throughout history, this has been shown to be the best way to invest, similar to your 401k, where you're always investing at a certain time, no matter what price it's at. Just remember, buying Bitcoin doesn't cause a taxable event, but selling it does. You will have to check off on your tax return that you've bought, sold, or acquired any cryptocurrencies during the tax year, but you won't have to report any details for any purchases you made throughout that year. If you ever do decide to sell, you will need all of that transaction detail to determine your basis and which Bitcoins you're selling to determine your capital gains or loss. So those are my four recommendations of what you can do to simplify your Bitcoin taxes and not have to worry about a complexity of tax issues when it comes to filing your return. If you like this video, please subscribe, like, and comment below. Thank you all for watching.